Hello everyone, welcome to my new episode, and today I'm going to prepare a very traditional dish and very common in each and every houses. It's called karil de kamara con mango. Actually we call prawn curry with slice of mango, and it's perfect eaten with thick red rice, Goan rice, which are grown in our own field. It goes very well, and it is always accompanied with side dish like small fried fish or small fried prawns on the side and little bit of pickle on the side. So that's the best way to eat either prawn curry or fish curry. There may be 100 dishes on your table for the big buffets and big functions, especially Goan. If there is no prawn curry or fish curry on the table, you don't feel that you have complete your meal. You have finished your meal or you have complete your meal. That's why fish curry or prawn curry is a must for all the people of Goa. Actually, the traditional prawn curry is always, in olden days, we used to cook it on wood fire on a chula. And in a clay pot, in a small kitchen, a smoky dark kitchen, where there is smoke used to come and kitchen has become very dark. But nowadays it's not there, but people still, there are kitchens, they are using it and they are making it. And in the clay pot, and they used to use bove water, our own sea pen, which are grown, harvesting in our fields, we used to use the rock salt from that sea salt pen. But nowadays we got the powder, everything is ready made, and it's becoming very easy for our own people. And we used to grind these masalas all together, combination of these all spices, on a masala hand grinding grinder like this, but this is a bigger one. So nowadays we put it in the mixer and freak, within no time it gets ready. Anyhow, but those days are different and now it's changed. You have to carry on according to the time. These are the ingredients which goes to the traditional prawn curry. And this is what I've learned from my mother's kitchen, how they used to make it. First of all, you need the very, very, very fresh prawns. Not the ice one, but it should be very fresh, which has come from the ponds like rivulets. At the back, we have rivulets in the downfield, or we have the salt pans or sluice we have. From there, it is to get the prawns. And those are very, very tasty. See, these are the fresh prawns, white prawns I have taken. I just add the salt to it and keep it. I'll put the rock salt to it and just keep it. By the time I've taken mangoes, raw mangoes, I peel it first, then I slice it, then I apply salt to it and just keep it. The most important is the masala. The following ingredients goes to the masala. First of all, you require very fresh grated coconut. Say 1 number grated coconut. 6 to 7 chilies, Kashmiri, red dry chilies. 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds. 4 to 5 garlic flakes. 1/2 inch of ginger. 5-6 number peppercorn. 1 small marble like ball of tamarind, no seeds should be there in the tamarind. 1/2 tablespoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 tablespoon of cumin seeds. This all you put in the grinder like this, or in the blender or mixer, and add 1 teacup of water. If you are smart, you will not throw out the, when you break this coconut water out, you will add that water to the mixer so that it get a natural flavor. You put it in a grinder with the 1 teacup of water and grind it till it becomes a fine paste. You will get like this paste. I'll keep the pot on fire. I will add this ground masala to it. Some people, they like to saute the onions, saute the tomatoes, they want to put tomatoes, they want to put onions with the oil. But actually never use oil in our curries, because coconut itself is oily. But if you want, you can put onion, just slice of onion in it, that's all. And if you want, you can put tomato also, but there's no harm. But we don't put it, actually it doesn't go. Tomato or saute onions, we don't do it. I will add this masala to the frying pan, to the curry pot. I'll add little water to it. I'll take one small onion and chop it fine. Finely chop. Then I'll add little salt to it and mix it. Why we have to add salt? To become onion soft, otherwise it remains crunchy. So I'll add it to the curry onion. Now I'll add two number slit green chili to it. The masala is getting little boil. I'll add a mango to it and let it get cooked for some time. See, I already put the mango in it. Since nowadays the mango season, everywhere there are mangoes. So we use season time mangoes to it. Sometimes you can use anything. You use sometimes even vegetable, you use it like okra, bhindi. Then we use kokum to eat. So it's up to you. Then tamarind. You don't require more tamarind to eat when you put a raw mango in it, because mangoes, raw mangoes are a little sour. So you have to be careful with that. So you can use it. It's up to you. It depends upon the season, how, what you get it in the backyard of your house, or bhimli you can put. You can use anything. Radish also, that's a vegetable, but souring agents are bhimli, kokum, mango, then tamarind. These are very common. But vegetable you can use, white radish we can use. You can use bhindi, you can use white pumpkin also. It's up to you. So mangoes are almost cooked. So now I'll add a marinated prawns to it and cook about 10 minutes, that's all. Now I'll add little salt to it. Sorry. Prawns are almost ready. Curry also, prawns are cooked and curry is ready. This curry really goes well with, especially with the kanji. Now, when we cook it in olden days, we used to cook the curry and the leftover curry, next day we used to make it hot and make it dry, and that is we call kalchi kodi. Yesterday's curry leftover, we used to cook it and we used to serve it with the kanji. It goes very well and so tasty. You want, and if you add little slice of onions to it and little of grated coconut in it, and just cook it little for some time till it become dry, you will not leave it. It's so tasty and goes very well with the kanji. So it's cooked, prawns are almost cooked and everything is ready. Curry is ready to serve it. I already put in the bowl and serve with this Goan fat rice. And as an accompaniment with that curry, it goes very crispy fried fish and little bit of fresh mango pickle I made it. We call korum of it, korum in Konkani. That is very tasty. It goes very well with the rice curry and fish and that together. Thank you very much for watching this episode. I hope you will enjoy this curry and prepare it at home and give me the comments. Thank you very much and God bless you.